Your site's information architecture is one of Google's 200 ranking factors. Not only that, if visitors can find their desired information easily on your website, it also means that you are offering a great user experience, which again influences SEO. Hi, Robert here from Themeisle.com, and in this video I will show you 3 steps to improve WordPress on-page SEO with the perfect site content structure, so keep watching. Your WordPress on-page SEO structure mainly reflects in the site's navigation, the main menu especially, and keywords play a big role here. To create a keyword-optimized main menu, start by brainstorming a bunch of broad keywords. These keywords will be used as items on your main menu, as well as the submenu items. So, list all the keywords you plan to target. Let me explain. For example, if you have a website about tea, you might want to start by doing some broad-level keyword research to discover the terms you should try to rank for. So, begin by googling your topic, in this case tea. When you scroll down to the bottom of the first results page, you'll see that people who search for tea also search for keywords like types of teas, tea benefits and tea brands. Since these are all relevant keywords, you must add them to your list. These terms will go into your site's main menu. Of course, they are too broad and competitive, but they matter to your target audience. So you must optimize your site, content and structure for them. To get more keyword ideas, Google each of these suggestions. For example, search for the key phrase types of tiers. When you Google this, you'll see lots of tier types in the search results. And if you scroll all the way down on the page, you'll see even more keyword ideas. Add all those keywords also to your list. Now, because queries like green tea and herbal and free tea, fit tea detox, etc. are nothing but subsets of the key phrase types of teas, they'll get added as submenu items and not as items on the main menu. At the end of this step, you should have a list of keywords you are going to add to your menu as well as create content about. Next, we'll take these keywords and arrange them into a sturdy structure that supports your WordPress on-page SEO. The creators of Yoast, one of our top recommended blogging tools, tells that the structure of a website should be like a pyramid. So, in our example, if we just start placing the keywords into a structure of pyramid, we'll end up with a pyramid like this. As you can see, on the top you have the home page. Below it, in the main menu are items like tier types, tier benefits, shop tier, along with the typical site pages like about and contact. The keywords we've used in the main menu are all broad keywords. Now, let's say that you don't want to use subpages for the tier benefits menu item. It's alright, just write one awesome page where you tell the benefits of all the main tier types and link to every relevant article on your website about tier benefits. This is nothing but a cornerstone content piece that can help you rank your website for your target keyword, tea benefits. If you look at the submenu items, for example green tea, white tea, black tea, under the tea types menu item, you'll see that we're drilling down to a more specific level of information. And at the last level, you have the specific variations of green tea. Likewise, under the tea benefits menu item, we're again offering more thematic content based on the different popular tea types. Basically, we're systematically narrowing down from broad-level keywords to the long-tail ones. Once you've laid out your website's hierarchy using different menu and submenu items, your next step is to create an internal network of links between these posts, pages, and resources. Both search engines and users will use these links to explore more of the related content on your site. And this will significantly improve your WordPress site's SEO. So, how do you decide where to place these links and where they will point to? Well, this part is easy. All you need to do is link each page one level up and down the hierarchy. So, to create a rich internal link network in our example, we'll link each resource in the suggested manner. The following figure shows how the content of green tea gets linked to the page where we list the tier types, and also to each of the different types of green tea. To develop a rich internal link network, you need to follow this advice for each of the content pieces, pages, and posts on your site. Also, each time you publish new content, link to the existing resources on the site that may be relevant to that content. Thanks for watching. Click the parrot on the screen right now to subscribe, then click the bell and check send all notifications for this channel. This way, you'll be notified every time we upload our latest tutorials about WordPress. Share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question in comments below.